So now you're asking me, Goff, where can I get even cheaper FIFA coins? You better head over to Goldad's new website at Yoha. It's safe, it's reliable, and trust me, they're dishing out even cheaper FIFA coins. Woo! Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, I'm back. Yeah, I'm back. As you can definitely see, I'm 100% more black. Basically, the reason why I've been slacking lately is, as you can tell by my tan, I have been on holiday for 6 whole days. And it was amazing. I basically went to a dance festival called Hideout in Croatia. Now, those of you who are probably over the age of 16 have heard of this festival. It's literally amazing. It's just a week of getting on it, getting blacker, going jet skiing and just having fun. And that is exactly why you haven't really seen no videos. Now, for those of you who want to see the mad shit that I got up to, I'll leave my Instagram and my Snapchat. They should both be on the screen. Go over there, follow me and have a little look, mate. There was a lot of titty sucking and all sorts of weird shit. So go and have a look, I dare you. But today we're back with the videos, and today I've got, oh, a pretty sick confirmed, I'm gonna call it confirmations, because there's definitely confirmations and there's one or two rumors, but today we have got some of the biggest confirmed Premier League transfers we've had so far, and there's one big one that you all know I'm gonna be gassed about. Yep, Lacazette, yeah? Yeah, Lacazette. Yeah, I'm happy. But before we dive into today's video, lads, there's something I want to introduce you to. Because I know there's going to be a lot of you Football Manager kind of guys who are going to love this. Now, this is a game called Online Soccer Manager, or better known as OSM. You can literally go to the App Store on any device and go and download it. And trust me, you may as well, because if you're bored and you're not playing FIFA, this is just perfect. So as you can see here, we're going to pick our country. I mean, I'm obviously going to pick England. I mean, I'm not going to pick Germany, am I? Do I look German to you? And once we've chosen a country, we're then going to choose a club that they let us actually have. Now, we've got a few pretty decent options. We've got Watford, West Ham. Do you know West Ham? I've always had a soft spot for them. Then, as you can see here, we're going to sign the contract. So it's pretty realistic. You actually sign contracts and shit. Now, as soon as you've picked your squad, as soon as you've signed your contracts, it's then going to take you to the bench. And this is where this game gets pretty realistic. Because we're literally going to change around anything we want. We can change our formation. We can change the players. Now, I'm going to put, who am I going to put up front? Do you know what? Ayew. So I'm going to go with Ayew and Antonio. This could be a stupid move. In defense, I'm going to go, if you know Cresswell, you're a bit slow. So I'm going to go with Fonte instead. Literally, we can change this squad to whatever we want. Mate, we're even gonna choose a sponsor for our stands. Like, look at this. I can choose a sponsor who sponsors my actual pitch. This is unbelievably, this is just stupid. Oxfam. I can have Oxfam, or I can have WWF, or Wikipedia. These will sponsor my stadium, and I get to choose. We're then gonna come across to some of the options, and we're gonna take our team into training, and we're gonna boost our team up before we play against Arsenal. Look at this. We're gonna give us a 25% extra boost before we play against that opposition's Arsenal. This is a big, big game. And you know, our players gotta be ready. And for those of you who wanna take a quick look on how Online Soccer Manager actually works when you play in-game, look at this realistic feature that they've got. They call it the matchday experience, and it literally is like simulating an online match. Look at this, you get your own commentators. It shows you when a goal is scored. It shows you when there's been a missed chance. And this is all available to download and play on your phone. How much more, what more do you want? If you can't be bothered to sit and watch the matchday experience, you can always skip and see the end result. But trust me, I definitely recommend sitting and watching this through, because it's so realistic. But anyway, lads, if you lot are interested in Online Soccer Manager, I'll leave a link in the description. Get over there, download it, and give it a go. But of course, lads, what you're here to see today is some hot shit. Some hot transfer news, and what I'm about to bring you, oh, you're gonna be surprised, because our first player of the day is actually a confirmation. Yes, today it's been confirmed that Leicester have signed Seville midfielder Vincent Ibora. Wow, now that has come out of nowhere, because he is meant to be a very talented centre defensive midfielder. He's already had 2 informs this year, and him joining Leicester. Now, I didn't see that coming, did you? Apparently they've signed him for an undisclosed fee of 10.5 mil, but I'm also seeing it's more around about 13 mil. Now, this guy was at Seville for over 4 years and managed to score himself 24 goals and 113 appearances. Considering he's a central defensive midfielder, That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Considering they lost one of the best central defensive midfielders or the best centre midfielders in the world, Kante, trust me, I rate this guy that highly. Bringing this guy in, is he going to fill the boots? We're going to find out very soon, but to me, that looks like a good signing. We then, of course, move up to John Terry, Mr. JT. Not going to lie, mate, I've never liked you. You probably wouldn't like me either. Considering I'm black, oh, that was below the belt. But he's been known to be racist. Just saying. Now, as 95% of football fans watching this video all know, John Terry a couple of days ago did go on to sign for Aston Villa. I think he signed a one-year deal. Yeah, a one-year deal. And trust me, I've seen better photoshops than that. I do like that kit though, I'm not gonna lie. That is a nice kit. If that was Nike or Adidas, I think that'd be one of the best kits we'd see this year. John Terry has gone on to be one of the best defenders the world has ever seen. Not just in the Premier League, but everywhere. He's been one of the most feared defenders in the whole of Europe. And when Chelsea were at their best, John Terry was leading the whole team. He was the captain. He was the guy. Now, let's not beat around the bush. We all know John Terry was one hell of a goal scorer. If you needed a headed goal, in the 65th minute, when it's literally been a stalemate, John Terry pops up with his big, fat, clumpy head and gets on the end of it. And he's been known to do this on, I think he scored up with 60-odd goals for a centre-back. That's just ridiculous. That's absolutely incredible. And as much as I hate him and I don't like him as a person, you can never take away the fact that John Terry was one of the best to ever do it. And his talent as a defender and as a captain was up there. And for that, I take my hat off to him. And hopefully Aston Villa, he can go on to just carry on doing good things. Even though he's coming to the end of his career, Terry probably still got it in him, so we're gonna find out. Now, Oliver Giroud seems to be popping up in a lot of my transfer videos recently, doesn't he, lad? Not gonna lie. With his shit half beard and his bench skills, this guy is literally a bench warmer, because that's all he's gonna be if he stays at Arsenal, is a bench warmer. Giroud, you've done great things, but if Sanchez and Lacazette are both gonna be playing this season, I think it's time for you to move on. As you can see here, lads, I do have an article from Sky Sports that says, we've obviously Lukaku's moved to Manchester United. This could pave the way for Oliver Giroud. This is pretty matting. Like, is Giroud gonna be going to Everton? Everton have made Giroud their number one target as they look to continue their summer spending with a 20 mil move for the Arsenal striker. They're not gonna pay 20 mil for Giroud. Good luck. The French international's future at the Emirates is in doubt following a big money move for Alexander Lacazette, which we're gonna talk about later. But Giroud, you've done okay for us, but maybe it's time for you to fuck off! Sorry. We then have an ex-Arsenal player, Lucas Podolski. Now, his time at Arsenal was great. I loved him. I honestly thought Podolski was sick. He then obviously went on to move to Galatasaray and he's just sort of fizzled out a little bit. But now it looks like he's going to be moving on again. Like, Podolski, when is it time that you just hang up those boots? It does seem like Podolski's had such a long career. I mean, I remember the days when he was at Bayern Munich. I mean, I think then he moved to another team in the German league. I can't remember what they were called, but he seems to have played for every team in the world. And now we have another confirmation because it looks like the Japanese club Vissel Kobe have welcomed German striker Lucas Podolski this morning. Podolski has moved from Galatasaray and signed a deal estimated to be worth £5.3 million. And as you can see here, Lucas Podolski has actually tweeted a picture of him buzzing to be there. Like, if there's a load of Japanese guys who actually rate you, and actually are beyond you supporting you, good luck. And I'm like, once again, I wish you all the best, but Japan, mate, really? I'm surprised they even play football in Japan. Next up, we have one that's blown a lot of people's minds recently, because Diego Costa, we knew he was probably gonna be leaving, but did anyone know that he was gonna be joining Atletico Madrid? That's right, as you can see, I've got an article here that says, European paper talk. Diego Costa to sign for Atletico Madrid today. So you're watching this video today. By the end of today, Diego Costa could be an Atletico Madrid player. And then this, believe it or not, coming from the Telegraph literally an hour ago. You know I bring you the freshest, hottest news. Diego Costa apparently has gone and said goodbye to his Chelsea teammates. Diego Costa is literally about to leave and about to join Atletico Madrid tonight. He's always been a top striker, but back to Spain is probably the best place for him. We then obviously, have Alexandre Lacazette. As we all know, one of the most deadliest strikers in Europe at the moment. By far, probably the best striker in France at the moment. And now, yes now, he is a confirmed Arsenal player. Oh! He's gonna be causing absolute damage this season, and every single person watching this video, you have to agree, he is the perfect guy for Arsenal. So it reminds me a little bit of Thierry Henry. Those of you who for some reason haven't seen the news, even though it's about a couple of days outdated now, Lacazette have posted up pictures of him in an Arsenal top. We've posted up pictures. Arsenal have sat ourselves to post up pictures of Lacazette. And it's confirmed that, as you can see, we signed him for 46.5 mil. And it was a battle, because at some point I didn't think we were going to get him. Especially when we were bidding on 30 odd mil, and there was teams like West Ham outbidding us. But eventually, we prevailed and we have now signed one of the best, one of my favourite strikers. He is one of the guys who I wanted. He's pacey, he's got the strength, he's got everything a perfect Arsenal striker needs. And hopefully, he's going to do bits. Oh, but now on to the news you've all been waiting for. Every Man United fan has been sitting here ripping their ears out, ripping their hair out all morning. Not sure what's going on. Because to be honest, I wasn't that sure either. But apparently, get this lads, apparently, Manchester United have finally agreed a 70-odd mil deal for Romelu Lukaku. And this is no bullshit. This is no Photoshop bullshit. Apparently this has happened today, like in the last hour or two. You can literally sit here and read this with your own eyes. Romelu Lukaku, Manchester United have agreed a 75 mil fee with the Everton striker. This is 24 minutes old since I was just recording this video. This is literally, you'll be watching this maybe in the next hour or two since I've recorded it. So this is fresh. Today, yes, right now, Man United have agreed a 75 mil fee. Like, this is unbelievable. Man United are literally throwing the dollar bills out. When are Man United ever gonna go broke? Like, they just seem to be buying everyone. And they just, no fucks are given. But that is gonna round up today's transfers, lads. We have seen Lacazette join Arsenal. We have seen Giroud possibly, finally get off the bench. We've seen Lukaku make his way towards Man United. We've seen Costa possibly fuck off back to Spain. We've seen Podolski, for some reason, go Japan. And we've seen John Terry, of course, sign for Aston Villa. Not forgetting Ibora, Leicester City signed in Ibora. It's been an interesting one. But the question we all want to know is, who's going to win the league next year? It's going to be fun. I'll answer you right now, I don't know what he was doing. I have no idea what he was doing. I don't even think he knows what he was doing. But this is just a standard game between two Mexican teams. And on the half-hour mark, Christian Vargas does that.